Hello everyone. I hope I'm clearly visible and audible to you people. Let me confirm it. If I'm clearly visible audible, I will start the lecture ahead. Just give me few seconds to confirm it. Okay, so I hope it's work. It is working. Okay, so welcome to this session. So today I am going to continue my pharmacology series. I am Dr. Priyanka Sachdev here and I am welcoming you for this session. And I have started systemic pharmacology. In systemic pharmacology, I have already started CVS, cardiovascular system. In CVS, we have to study five systems. So drugs acting on RAS, that is renin-angiotensinogen system. We have already finished this lecture. It is available on YouTube. Those who have missed it, they can watch it. They can watch the recording. Then second is anti-anginal drug. We have also covered this chapter. That is nitrates, the most important drug in that is nitrates. We have covered this chapter again. It is available on YouTube and you can watch the recording anytime if you have missed it. Today I am going to start the third chapter, that is drug acting for heart failure. Very important, digoxin. The most important drug today is digitalis or digoxin, which that is a cardiac glycoside, which I will continue in my today's lecture. I will finish in today's lecture. Done. The fourth chapter is anti-hypertensive, that will be tomorrow, and antiarrhythmic drugs again a day after tomorrow. So I will cover the complete cardiovascular system from cover to cover. All five chapters will be covered. So today I am going to continue with heart failure, drugs for heart failure. Before understanding the drugs for heart failure, you should understand what is heart failure. If you can understand what is the problem in heart failure, so understanding the mechanism of drug for you is very easy. So let me first, in the 5 minutes, I will give you an overview. What is heart failure? What is heart failure? Then I will, as usual, I will teach you the pathophysiology of heart failure in the just 5 minutes. After that, I will teach you mechanism of action of various drugs, the classification of the drugs. I will come on pharma. So what is heart failure? So before understanding what is heart failure, you should understand what is preload, what is afterload. What is preload? Should you have you understand what is preload, what is afterload? Preload kya hota hai? Afterload kya hota hai? You should understand it for understanding heart failure. So you can see, this is a rough sketch diagram of a heart. You can see the four chambers. This is the left side. This is the right side in front of you. You can see the four vessels arising from the four chambers of the heart. You know the two arteries and the two veins. You already know it. This is the complete circle. You already know the cycle of the heart. So you already know it. Now listen, what is preload? What is afterload? Let me explain you. What is preload? Let me come on preload first. What is preload? The definition of the preload, it is end diastolic pressure when the ventricles are filled. So it is the end diastolic pressure in the ventricles, in this ventricle and in this ventricle, when the heart is doing diastole, not systole, when the heart is doing diastole, end diastolic pressure, end diastolic at the end of the diastolic. So it depends on the venous return. What is venous return? How much blood is coming from superior inferior vena cava? Jitna blood superior inferior vena cava se right auricle mein aayega, utna hi right ventricle mein jayega. So that is constituting preload. So preload depends on venous return. That you have to understand. Venous return jitna zyada hoga, utna preload zyada hoga. So preload is directly proportional to venous return. More is the venous return via superior inferior vena cava, more blood will come in the right auricle and right ventricle. More blood will be present at that end of the diastole and more will be the preload. More will be the preload. That is the definition of preload. You should understand what is preload. So preload depends on venous return. Preload depends on veins. Veins, the diameter of the veins. If the diameter of the veins is more, most of the blood will remain in veins only and it will not come in the heart. So preload will be less. And if the diameter is less, vessel constriction is there. So most of the blood will come in the heart and it will increase the preload. So the summary is that preload is directly proportional to venous return, to the diameter of the veins, whether it is showing vasoconstriction or vasodilatation. Veins, not arteries, veins. It is SVC and IVC. Coming on afterload, what is afterload? Afterload is how much pressure the left ventricle has to apply during systole to eject the blood into the aorta. Aorta, afterload, you know. So left ventricle has to do systole. So it has to increase the pressure so that blood is ejected into the aorta. That depends on the lumen of the aorta. If the lumen of the aorta is more, less pressure only has to be applied. If the lumen of the aorta is less, it is vessel constriction, more pressure has to be applied. So it is the artery, aorta is the artery, right? So it depends on artery. So that is afterload. So afterload, agar aorta vessel constricted hoga, to heart ko zyada pressure apply karna padega. Agar aorta vessel dilated hoga, to heart ko left ventricle ko zara sa pressure apply karna padega. So the pressure the left ventricle has to apply during systole. That is afterload. So afterload depends on arteries. You know, so what is the summary? Preload and afterload. There are two loads, preload and afterload. If you can understand it now, you will understand heart failure and the drugs for heart failure in a much better way. So preload depends on venous return and afterload depends on aorta. So preload depends on veins and afterload depends on arteries. So the lumen, that is vessel constriction or vessel dilatation of the veins, will decide preload either more or less. And the vasoconstriction and vasodilatation of the arteries will decide whether the afterload will be more or less. Give me a thumbs up if you can understand it. Everyone give me a thumbs up. I know you already know this concept in your physiology. You have read all these in the physiology. But knowing this is really important in this chapter. So that is preload and afterload. What is the function of the heart? Why God has given this heart, this organ to human beings? So heart has one function. It collects impure blood on the right side. Send, pump this impure blood to the lungs for purification. Lungs will do the purification and the pure blood is collected on the right left side and it is ejected to the heart. So heart is collecting impure and doing it purification in the lung and the pure blood is ejected in the heart. That is the function of the heart. We know. Now what is heart failure? Let me come on the topic. Drugs for the heart failure pe baad mein aayenge. Heart failure kya hai? Heart is unable to perform its function. Heart is unable to perform its function. Heart is unable to do the pumping. When right ventricle is doing the systole, blood is going in the lungs for purification. When left ventricle is doing the systole, pure blood is going into the aorta and distributed in the body. Give me a thumbs up. Heart is unable to do its function. Whether heart is unable to do the systole or unable to do the diastole or systole, diastole, both are normal. The body demand is high. Give me a thumbs up if you can understand this classification. The most important among them, most common among them is systolic dysfunction. Heart is unable to do systole. Heart is unable to empty the ventricle. Now, if right ventricular failure is there, right ventricle is unable to do the systole. So blood will not move forward. Blood will move backward and it will get collected. It will get collected in the organs and all organs will show edema. All organs will show edema and right ventricular failure. If left ventricle is unable to do the systole, so blood will not go in the aorta because left ventricle is not doing the adequate systole. So blood will not move forward. Blood will move backward. In the backward, it will move to the lungs and it will show pulmonary edema. So we already know that right heart failure leads to edema of all organs. That is anasarca. Anasarca is edema of all organs. Anasarca. And left heart failure leads to pulmonary edema. Only one organ edema, that is pulmonary edema, not all organ edema. We know it. So that is systolic dysfunction. Systolic dysfunction, most common cause is ischemia of the wall of the heart. Of the wall of the left ventricle, there is ischemia. So that heart is unable to do the systole. So unable to do the ejection. Now you know it. Second is diastolic function. Heart is unable to fill properly. Systole to karna hai. These two ventricles are doing proper systole. But they are unable to show the diastole. They are unable to do the relaxation. There is a problem in relaxation. They are unable to do the relaxation. So if they are not relaxing, blood cannot come properly from auricles into the ventricles. Ab auricles se ventricles mein blood aayega hi nahi, to yahan pe jayega kaise? That is diastolic dysfunction. So that is stiffness of the heart. And third is systole and diastole. Both are normal. But body demand is high. During pregnancy, during thyrotoxicosis, beriberi, severe anemia, body demand is high. So that is the three types of heart failure you should know. Systolic and diastolic dysfunction are known as low output heart failure. Why they are known as low output? If there is systole dysfunction or there is diastole dysfunction, less blood will move here and here. Less blood will go. Less blood. Systole may be kam jayega, systolic failure may be, diastolic failure may be. That's why these two, systolic dysfunction and diastolic dysfunction, these are known as low output heart failure. And the third is, systole is normal. Diastole is also normal. Systole, diastole, both are normal. So blood is moving here normally, na? But the demand of the body is high. Demand is high. So it is known as high output heart failure. So high body demand comes in, high output cardiac failure. Most important I will consider here only is one, systolic dysfunction. Okay, these are apart. Now the most important funda which you should understand before studying the drugs for heart failure is compensatory mechanism. Now God has given us a compensatory mechanism if heart failure is there, if systolic dysfunction is there. If systolic dysfunction is there, this compensatory mechanism automatically come in role. Automatically God will start it. Automatically it will come in role. So is it useful for us or not useful for us? First understand it. So what is the compensatory mechanism? Listen, as soon as systolic dysfunction is there, listen, most commonly it is left ventricle. Listen, I am imagining a situation. You imagine a situation. This is left ventricle. Everyone see here. Please everyone see the diagram. This is left ventricle. Left ventricle is unable to do the systole. Imagine a situation. Systole nahi kar pa raha because the wall of the left ventricle is damaged. It is showing ischemia. It is unable to do the systole. What will happen? Blood cannot go ahead. So body will do the compensation. What the body will do the compensation? What is the compensation here? The wall of the left ventricle contains beta 1 receptor, right? Beta 1 receptors are present on the wall. We know it, na? Beta 1 yahan pe present hota hai. So beta 1 receptor is present on the wall of the heart. Say yes or no, it is present. So in the form of the compensation, God will stimulate, increase the secretion of noradrenaline. That is sympathetic stimulation. So sympathetic stimulation ki wajah se there is more noradrenaline. And that noradrenaline will come and bind with the beta 1 receptor. That will cause the stimulation of beta 1 receptor in the heart. This beta 1 receptor will get stimulated and it will cause more contraction. Systole aur zyada karega, normal se bhi zyada karega, so that blood moves out. So you will say, ma'am, it is good now. If the heart is doing systolic dysfunction, automatically in the body sympathetic stimulation is taking place, noradrenaline concentration is increasing and it is binding to beta 1 receptor in the heart and it is increasing the systole. So the problem is resolved. Why you are teaching us the drug for heart failure? Already it is treated by the compensation. There should be no requirement for the drug. Ye to compensation se hi ho jayega, theek. Agar systole nahi ho pa raha, to beta 1 receptor stimulate hoke compensation se usko theek kar denge. What is the problem? I will tell you the problem. Okay. So yahan tak theek hai. Compensatory mechanism ki wajah se there is increased sympathetic activity. So that is increased noradrenaline concentration in the blood. That noradrenaline will go to the beta 1 receptors on the heart, stimulate the heart and increase the cardiac output. Increase the systole, increase the cardiac output. You will say, ma'am, it is good thing for us. It is good. It is very good. The disease is treated. What was the problem? Heart was unable to do the systole, na? Now systole is done. The problem is resolved. Even without drugs, it is resolved. It is known as compensatory mechanism. Compensatory mechanism is good for us in this aspect. But there are two bad aspects also. There are two bad aspects for this compensatory mechanism. What are the two bad aspects? This is now this table you already know. This is the table for alpha and beta receptors from KDT. You know, na? So beta 1 receptors on the heart got stimulated and they are increasing the cardiac output as a compensatory mechanism. But noradrenaline in the blood is increased, na? There are two other bad effects also due to this increased noradrenaline in the blood. This increased noradrenaline will go to alpha receptors also and to beta 1 receptors in the kidney also. Not only in heart, beta 1 present in kidney also. So alpha receptors on the blood vessels and beta 1 receptors on the kidney. Alpha receptors on the blood vessel, it causes vasoconstriction. This noradrenaline is causing vasoconstriction. You know, if there is decreased cardiac contractility, God has given this compensatory mechanism. Because of this compensatory mechanism, noradrenaline in the blood is increasing. So this noradrenaline in the blood is it was going to the heart and causing increased contraction. That was good. But it is going to the blood vessels also, stimulating alpha receptors and causing vasoconstriction. Vasoconstriction of the artery means vasoconstriction of the artery. Artery ka vasoconstriction or vein ka vasoconstriction. Listen, artery matlab aorta. Artery matlab aorta. Aorta ka vasoconstriction ho gaya. Imagine, aorta ka vasoconstriction ho gaya. So afterload ka kya hoga? Afterload ka kya hoga? Aorta is too narrow. So this left ventricle have to do more pumping to eject the blood into the aorta. Because it is vasoconstricted, it is not good. Heart has already failed. Heart is unable to do the pumping. Upar se sone pe suhaga. Tumne aur vasoconstriction kar diya aorta ka. To heart ka workload aur badh gaya. Have you got it? This is bad. This is not good. This is bad. And vasoconstriction of the vein. Vein means SVC, IVC. Can you see this SVC, IVC? This is a vein. Iska vasoconstriction ho gaya. So all the blood present inside this vein because of the vasoconstriction of this SVC IVC, it will come in the right auricle. So more blood will come in the right auricle, more venous return. So more preload bhi badh gaya. तो और काम बढ़ गया, मोर ब्लड आया तो ये पूरा का पूरा ब्लड यहाँ पंप करके यहां से लेके वापस चेक करना पड़ेगा. सो मोर ब्लड, हार्ट का वर्क बढ़ गया. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कॉम्पनसेशन, अच्छी चीज तो एक हुई, बुरी चीजें दो हो गई. गिव मी अ थम्स अप इफ यू गॉट इट. बुरी चीज एक तो ये हुई कि वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रक्शन हो गया आर्टरी का भी, वेन का भी. आर्टरी का वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रक्शन मतलब एओटा का वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रक्शन, मतलब आफ्टर लोड बढ़ गया. और वेन का वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रक्शन मतलब एसवीसी आईवीसी का वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रक्शन, मतलब प्री लोड बढ़ गया. तो प्री लोड भी बढ़ गया, आफ्टर लोड भी बढ़ गया बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कॉम्पनसेशन इंक्रीज नॉर एड्रेनलिन की वजह से. गिव मी अ थम्स अप. दूसरा, दिस नॉर एड्रेनलिन विल गो टू द किडनी. ऑन द किडनी इट विल स्टिमुलेट बीटा 1 रिसेप्टर्स ऑन द किडनी. इट विल इंक्रीज रेनिन सेक्रीशन फ्रॉम जेजे अपैरेटस. रेनिन आएगा, रेनिन विल कन्वर्ट एंजियोटेंसिनोजन 1 टू एंजियोटेंसिन 2, एंड एंजियोटेंसिन 2 विल डू सॉल्ट एंड वाटर रिटेंशन. सो बॉडी में सॉल्ट एंड वाटर ज्यादा है, बॉडी में मोर सॉल्ट एंड वाटर, मोर वीनस रिटर्न, इंक्रीज वर्कलोड इन द हार्ट, इंक्रीज वर्कलोड ऑफ द इन द हार्ट, अगेन इट इज अ बैड थिंग. Have you got it? So this renin is converting angiotensinogen into angiotensin 1. Angiotensin 1 will get converted into angiotensin 2 by ACE. And this angiotensin 2 will cause cardiac remodeling. Have you got it? So it is a bad thing. Okay, I will draw a diagram for you and I will start with the drugs. Listen, those who can understand this now, only those students can understand the chapter ahead. Listen, what is happening? This is heart. This is heart. This is left side. Everyone understand. This is right side. Done. This is heart. Now, what is the problem? Heart is failed. There is heart failure. The problem here is that heart is failed. Heart failure is there. Heart failure means left ventricle is unable to doing systole or doing less systole as compared to normal. The heart is failed. Imagine this heart is failed. So God has given a compensatory mechanism. So because of this compensatory mechanism, noradrenaline, the God has increased the concentration of noradrenaline in the blood. So because of compensation, this noradrenaline is increasing. This noradrenaline is going to three organs. On three organs, it is going. It is going to heart itself. It is going on the blood vessels, in the arteries and in the veins. And it is going to the kidney. Okay. In the heart, beta 1 receptors are present. In the blood vessels, arteries and veins, alpha receptors are present. And in the kidney, JJ receptors, again beta 1 is present. So this noradrenaline is going to all three. This noradrenaline is going to beta 1 receptors in the heart, stimulate them. Alpha receptors in the arteries and veins, stimulate them. And JJ apparatus of the kidney, stimulate them. What will happen? Three things will happen. One is good, two are bad. Total three things will happen because of this increased sympathetic activity. Sympathetic activity is increased. It is compensatory mechanism. Sympathetic activity is increased. It is increased by automatically by God due to decreased systole. Systole kam tha yahan pe, isliye ye hua. So listen, here the good thing is only this one. This is the good thing. So beta 1 receptors on the heart will be stimulated. So systole, the ejection, the systole of the heart will increase. So contractility of the heart is increased. So you will say, ma'am, it is good. Na, contractility kam thi, isliye to hua. So contractility bad gai. What is the problem? Okay, it is good. I agree it is good. What are the two bad things? This noradrenaline going to blood vessels also. Arteries and veins. Okay, it is causing vasoconstriction of arteries also, vasoconstriction of the veins also. Vasoconstriction of the arteries means increasing afterload. And vasoconstriction of the veins means increasing preload. तो हार्ट पहले से ही फेल हो गया है, आपने आफ्टर लोड भी बढ़ा दिया, प्री लोड भी बढ़ा दिया, सोने पे डबल सुहागा. सो इट इज नॉट गुड फॉर द हार्ट. एंड दूसरा थिंग, इट इज गोइंग, नॉरएड्रेनालिन इज गोइंग टू द किडनी, इट इज स्टिमुलेटिंग बीटा 1 रिसेप्टर्स ऑन द जेजे अपैरेटस, सो इट इज इंक्रीजिंग रेनिन सेक्रेशन. दिस रेनिन विल कम इन द ब्लड एंड कन्वर्ट एंजियोटेंसिनोजन इनटू एंजियोटेंसिन 1. Angiotensin 1 will get converted into angiotensin 2, and this angiotensin 2, what it will do? It will go to the heart. Number one, it will do sodium water retention. So sodium water retention, the body may, there is more fluid. So again, preload afterload bad gaya. It is not good. Number one. Number two, this angiotensin 2 will go to the heart and it will increase. It will cause the hypertrophy of the wall of the left ventricle. You know, hypertrophy is increase in size. So increase in size hona achhi baat hai ki buri baat hai. You will say, ma'am, heart ki wall ki thickness agar badh gayi, to systole aur zyada hoga, to ye to achhi baat hai. No, it is not a good thing. It is known as remodeling and it is permanent. Huh? This remodeling is, it is reversible, but it is the most common cause of mortality in heart failure. So it is not a good thing. So remodeling is not a good thing. So it is doing two bad things. So these two things are bad. Only one thing is good. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So this is the whole thing. This is the whole scenario taking place. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So listen, what is my point? My point is that the patient is having a disease known as heart failure. Means his heart is not pumping. This is the heart of the patient. Let me show you the heart. Okay, it is not there. So patient is having heart failure. Just a second. Patient is heart failure. That is, left ventricle is not pumping. It is not doing the systole. So due to decreased cardiac contractility, due to decreased contractility, compensatory mechanism will come in the role. So it will increase the contractility of the heart. That is one good thing. But two bad things are happening. That is, alpha stimulation on the blood vessel causing vasoconstriction of arteries as well as veins, increasing preload and afterload. And beta 1 stimulation of the kidney, JJ apparatus, increase renin secretion, formation of angiotensinogen 1. Angiotensinogen 1 will get converted into angiotensin 2. It will secrete aldosterone also from the adrenal gland. It will cause salt and water retention number 1 and causes cardiac remodeling or hypertrophy number 2. So that is the problem. These two things are not good for humans. These are bad. So one good thing is happening due to compensation, increased contractility, and two bad things are happening. Give me a thumbs up. So I will teach you the drugs for heart failure, digoxin, many drugs are there. I will teach you all. All of them are working to inhibit this compensatory mechanism. To God ne compensatory mechanism diya hi kyun? Ye hamare liye faydemand nahi hai. Faydemand ek aspect se hai ki ye contractility badha raha hai. लेकिन दो एस्पेक्ट से वो नुकसान कर रहा है. तो वॉट एवर ड्रग्स आई विल टीच यू, मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर टू कॉम्पनसेट फॉर दिस कॉम्पनसेटरी मैकेनिज्म. इस कॉम्पनसेटरी मैकेनिज्म को अपोज करने के लिए है सारी ड्रग्स. गिव मी अ थम्स अप इफ यू गॉट माई पॉइंट. सो दैट इज द डिजीज, दैट इज अ यूनिक डिजीज इन विच वी आर नॉट ट्रीटिंग द डिजीज, वी आर ट्रीटिंग द कॉम्पनसेशन कॉज्ड बाय द डिजीज बाय द गॉड. तो हम डिजीज को ट्रीट नहीं कर रहे हैं, हम डिजीज की वजह से बॉडी में जो कॉम्पनसेशन हुआ है, कॉम्पनसेशन की वजह से जो लॉस हो रहा है, उसको ट्रीट कर रहे हैं. गिव मी अ थम्स अप इफ यू गॉट इट. एवरीवन गिव मी अ थम्स अप. नाउ दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ हार्ट फेलियर. इट इज नोन एज न्यूयॉर्क हार्ट एसोसिएशन. न्यूयॉर्क हार्ट एसोसिएशन ने ये क्लासिफिकेशन दिया है. देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ हार्ट फेलियर. हार्ट फेलियर कैटेगरी 1, ग्रेड 1, ग्रेड 2, ग्रेड 3, ग्रेड 4. हियर हार्ट फेलियर इज देयर, बट सिम्टम्स, दैट इज पेशेंट हैव डिस्निया, राइट? इन लेफ्ट हार्ट फेलियर यूजुअली पेशेंट हैव डिस्निया बिकॉज ऑफ द बैक फ्लो ऑफ द ब्लड and causing pulmonary edema. So dyspnea is not at ordinary activity, it is at, means running, jogging, us pe hoga dyspnea. Ordinary activity are not affected normally, walking wagera affect nahi hoga. Grade 2 mein ordinary activity are also affected. Grade 3 mein activities are limited but relief at rest, and grade 4 mein rest pe bhi dyspnea hoga. So that is the New York classification. Now coming on the drugs for heart failure. So all the drugs of the heart failure are of two types. Number 1, most of the drugs, number 1, there are drugs which increase the contractility of the heart, and there are drugs which reduce the load of the heart, either preload or afterload. We will see which drug. So that is the classification in front of you. So there are inotropic drugs. Inotropic drugs are of three types. Number 1, digoxin, that is cardiac glycoside. Digoxin will be the main drug here. Sympathomimetics, dopamine and duobutamine, very, very important. And phosphodiesterase 3 inhibitors, PDE3 inhibitors, that is milrinone, Amrinone, milrinone. These are the drugs. After that, there are diuretics, there are aldosterone antagonists, beta blockers, alpha blockers, vasodilators, and RAS inhibitors. So I will tell you all the other drugs apart from inotropic drugs. Just a second. All these other drugs, apart from inotropic drugs, they will help in reducing the compensatory mechanism. How? I will show you. Listen, this is the compensatory mechanism. Everyone give me a thumbs up. You can understand it this now. Yes or no? So inotropic drugs are acting here. They are increasing the contractility. They are increasing. The main problem is contractility is decreased. What is the main problem? This is heart. This is heart. These are the four ventricles of the heart. So the problem is that this is left side. The problem is that the left ventricle is not pumping. So inotropic drugs are the drugs which increase the contractility. So main problem, jo contractility kam ho gayi hai, usko badhane ka kaam inotropic drugs karti hai. So inotropic drugs are the drugs which increase the contractility of the heart. only these are the drugs which are acting on the main disease. Rest, all the drugs are acting on compensation. Like alpha blockers will act on here, alpha on the blood vessels pe jo alpha receptors hain. उनको ब्लॉक करेगा तो वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन नहीं होगा, ना आर्टरीज का वैसो कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन होगा, वैसो डायलिटेशन होगा और वेन्स का भी वैसो डायलिटेशन होगा. सो दे डिक्रीज प्रीलोड एंड दे डिक्रीज आफ्टर लोड. सो अल्फा अल्फा ब्लॉकर्स आर डिक्रीजिंग प्रीलोड एंड डिक्रीजिंग आफ्टर लोड बाय कॉजिंग वैसो डायलिटेशन ऑफ द आर्टरीज एंड द वेन्स. गिव मी अ थम्स अप, दैट इज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ अल्फा ब्लॉकर्स. बीटा ब्लॉकर्स क्या करेंगे? बीटा ब्लॉकर्स विल इनहिबिट beta receptors on the kidney, so they will inhibit the renin secretion. That is beta blockers. Give me a thumbs up. So renin नहीं आएगा, तो that is the thing. Aldosterone antagonist क्या करेंगे? They will inhibit aldosterone secretion because of renin. That is aldosterone antagonist. ACE inhibitors क्या करेंगे? RAS inhibitors और ACE inhibitors. They will inhibit this complete sequence. Renin का angiotensinogen, angiotensinogen 1 का 2 में conversion रुकेंगे. Diuretics क्या करेंगे? Salt and water जो retention हुआ है, उस पूरे को urine में बाहर निकाल देंगे. That is diuretics का function. So have you understood? So ultimately workload on the heart को ये लोग कम कर रहे हैं. All the other drugs. Have you got it? All other drugs. So I can give inotropic drugs to increase the contractility. That is digoxin, number 1. I can give alpha blockers to oppose this. So that vasoconstriction नहीं होगा, vasodilatation होगा. Arteries and veins will have vasodilatation, so preload and afterload is reduced. Alpha blockers. I can give beta blockers. Beta blockers. Beta blockers यहाँ पे renin का secretion रोकेंगे. On the kidney, they will block the beta receptors in the kidney. I can give aldosterone antagonist. I can give diuretics so that whatever salt and water retention is there, it is excreted in the urine. So I can give aldosterone antagonist, I can give diuretics, I can give RAS inhibitor, ACE inhibitor. Have you got it? Give me a thumbs up. So all these drugs are acting at various pathways to decrease the compensation. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. One more thing I would like to tell you. Again, see, this is hard. No, it is complicated. Huh? What drugs you are giving, it is not the thing ki tumko ye pura bas, you have to mug it up. No, you have to understand it. Which drug? What is the mechanism of action of each drug? Everyone give me a thumbs up if you got it. So only inotropic drugs are the drugs which are increasing the contractility of the heart. What is the problem in heart failure? The problem in the heart failure is that left ventricle is not doing systole. This is left ventricle and it is not doing systole. Systole is not proper. Systole, left ventricle is not doing systole. This is the problem with heart failure. So inotropic drugs are the drugs which increases the contractility, which are increasing systole, which are increasing the contractility. So main drugs here are inotropic drugs. Give me a thumbs up. Main drugs. After that, rest all other drugs. That is diuretics, aldosterone antagonist, beta blocker, alpha blocker. Yahan likha nahi hai, aap likh lo. Alpha blocker, RAS inhibitors, and vasodilators. All these drugs, what they will do? What they will do? They are inhibiting the compensation. They are not increasing the contractility. They are reducing the workload. So all the other drugs are reducing the workload of the heart. Give me a thumbs up, everyone, if you got it. It's complicated. I'm trying hard. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Now, one more thing which I would like to add here. I was telling you this is heart. Huh? This is the left side of the heart. This is the left ventricle. The problem is that left ventricle is not contracting. You got it. You got it. Now, there are two things can happen. Either acute or chronic. What do you mean by acute and chronic? You already know. What is acute? What is chronic? You tell me. Acute means sudden. Acute means sudden. And chronic means slowly. Chronic means slowly. What is the difference if acute heart failure occurs or if chronic heart failure occurs? Is there any difference between the two? Yes. If acute is there, compensation do not come in role. Compensation ko role mein aane ke liye, it takes time. Acute, suddenly, this left ventricle stop pumping. So compensation is not there. It will take time for the body to come the compensatory mechanism. So here you have to give inotropic drugs only to increase the contractility for acute heart failure. If chronic heart failure is there, so heart is failing slowly, slowly, slowly every day. Pumping is not zero suddenly. It is decreasing out of 100%, 90, then 80, then 70, then 60. So slowly, slowly, slowly pumping is reduced. So compensatory mechanism is coming in the room. Compensatory mechanism. So here main drug are not inotropic drug. Inotropic drug ki to zarurat hi nahi hai yahan, because God is already increasing the pumping. एक अच्छी बात हो रही है, बट कॉम्पनसेटरी मैकेनिज्म जो हो रहा है उसके लिए रेस्ट ऑफ द ड्रग्स टू रिड्यूस द लोड, प्रीलोड एंड आफ्टर लोड यू हैव टू गिव. क्रॉनिक हार्ट फेलियर में द रेस्ट ऑफ द ड्रग्स आर मोर इंपॉर्टेंट. इन एक्यूट हार्ट फेलियर inotropic drugs are more important because compensation is absent. Give me a thumbs up if you can understand this. Now you can understand everything. I really tried hard. I'm asking you to give me a thumbs up in the chat box so that I will have a indication that you got my point. You got this is compensatory mechanism. Main problem to ye ek hi hai. Main problem sirf ye hai. ये इसको ठीक करना है तो आइनोट्रॉपिक ड्रग दे दो. कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी कम है बढ़ जाएगी, लेकिन मेन प्रॉब्लम कॉन्ट्रैक्टिलिटी कम होना नहीं है. उसकी वजह से गॉड ने जो कॉम्पनसेशन करके गड़बड़ कर दिया उसको ठीक करना है. गिव मी अ थम्स अप एवरीवन, गिव मी अ थम्स अप प्लीज, गिव मी अ थम्स अप. सो आई वुड लाइक टू लर्न सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस ऑन दिस एंड देन आई विल कम ऑन द ड्रग्स वन बाय वन. सो सी ऑल ऑफ द फॉलोइंग आर यूज्ड इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कंजेस्टिव हार्ट फेलियर एक्सेप्ट. द क्वेश्चन कंटेन्स एक्सेप्ट. प्लीज राइट डाउन योर आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स. The four options are in. Should I read the classification once for you for solving these questions? Okay, I will. Just a second. In inotropic drugs, you can see I have already read it. It is digoxin, it is dopamine, dobutamine, and imrinone and milrinone. These are the inotropic drugs. Diuretics, you already know the two classes: high ceiling furosemide, bumetanide, and thiazides. All thiazides are there: hydrochlorothiazide, metoclothiazide, zipamide. Aldosterone antagonist, you already know it is spironolactone. Beta blockers, you already know. It is metoprolol, bisoprolol, or lol. You know, vasodilators, there are three vasodilators: artery, vein, and combined. Arterial vasodilator is hydralazine. Venous dilator are nitrates, and both combined are nitroprusside. You have to learn it. And RAS inhibitors, I have taken this chapter now. So ACE inhibitors all pril, and ARBs are sartans, all sartans. Now you know the classification. You answer this question. Who will answer? Who will answer this question? All of the following drugs are used in the treatment of heart failure except. Is it nitroglycerin, spironolactone, nystyretide, and trimetazidine? Which is there in the except? What is your answer? Yes, most of you are right. The correct answer here is, of course, it is D. D is not used. Nitroglycerin, it is a venodilator. Spironolactone, it is a diuretic. And nystyrite, it is not there in the classification, but in others I will teach you this drug also. But trimetazidine, it is not a treatment. It is not a treatment wherever you can see here. This is the next drug. Okay, let it be. Yeah, again, the drug, which of the following is not useful? Again, same question with different options. Which of the following drug is not useful in the treatment of congestive heart failure? Which of the drug is not useful in the treatment of congestive heart failure? Who will tell me? Is it adrenaline? Is it digoxin? Is it hydrochlorothiazide or enalapril? Digoxin is a inotropic drug. Hydrochlorothiazide is a diuretic. Enalapril is the ACE inhibitor. We give all these three drugs, but we cannot give adrenaline. Adrenaline will increase the heart failure. Adrenaline, we cannot increase the sympathetic activity. No, adrenaline is not used. So the correct answer here is A. So you should know the classification for solving these questions. All of the following reduce afterload except. Which of the drug is not used in reducing afterload? So all of the drugs are used to reduce afterload except. Now how afterload is reduced? By causing afterload depends on arteries, right? If you do the vasodilatation of the arteries, that is aorta. Aorta ka agar vasodilatation karoge to afterload reduce hoga. So which of the following does not causes the vasodilatation of the aorta? You can tell me the answer. It is very easy. Beta blockers will be the answer. You know, enalapril, okay, how I will explain you. Hydralazine is a vasodilator. You know, sodium nitroprusside is also a vasodilator. You already know. What about ACE inhibitors? ACE inhibitors will also do the vasodilatation, but not the beta blockers. So you should know. Once I will teach you the mechanism of action of each of them, then it will be easy for you. So these are the drugs. Out of these two chapters are very important. First, I will start with inotropic drugs. Very, very important. The most important drug here is digoxin. I will explain you this. After that, I will come on the vasodilators. Three type of vasodilators: artery, vein, and combined. Arterial dilators, venodilators, and combined. So I will explain you these. Let me start with inotropic drugs. Inotropic drugs, as you can see, it is of three types: cardiac glycoside, sympathomimetics, and phosphodiesterase inhibitor. So I request you to make a comparative table between the three. Cardiac glycosides, what are the three types? Cardiac glycosides, sympathomimetic, and PDE3 inhibitors. Sympathomimetics and phosphodiesterase 3 inhibitors. So to make a comparative table, it will be easy for you. Let me start with the first one, cardiac glycosides. What are the drugs here in cardiac glycosides? All of them increase the contractility. They will increase the contractility of the heart. They will increase the contractility of the left ventricle. They will increase the contractility because the problem is that contractility is reduced. So they will increase the systole, in short. So that is known as cardiac glycosides or inotropic drugs. So what are the drugs here? The drugs collectively known as digitalis. Digitalis is a collective term. It includes two drugs, digoxin and digitoxin. Digoxin, see the spelling, digoxin and digitoxin combined, it is known as digitalis. So digitalis, very few students know this. So digitalis is a combination, it is a collective group, it is an umbrella term containing both. Digoxin also, digitoxin also. Two other drugs are also there. You should know the names Aubaine and Strofathin. But these are not used. But you should know there are four cardiac glycosides. So name them. It is digoxin. It is digitalis. Digoxin, digitoxin combination known as digitalis. Apart from it, Aubaine. And apart from it, Strofathin. So there is an MCQ on Aubaine. In PYQ, you can see this question. Ki which of the following is a cardiac glycoside? Option mein digoxin, digitalis, ye sab nahi diya tha. Option mein Aubaine. So you should know other name also. So there are four drugs here. Two are most commonly used. So digoxin and digitoxin are used. Both of them are obtained from plants. Name the plant from which it is obtained. Again a PYQ. You can see in the previous year papers it is asked. So digoxin is obtained from a plant known as digitalis lantana, and digitoxin is obtained from a plant known as digitalis purpura. They are obtained from the leaves of the plant, not from the bark, from the leaves of the plant, leaves of these plants. So name the plants, name the plants. You have to learn the name of the plants. So I will teach you digoxin. Digoxin is most commonly used. Digitoxin is not used. Digoxin is other commonly used. Done. So I will teach you digoxin here. So drugs are done. The most important and difficult portion of today's lecture is mechanism of action of digoxin. Either you say digoxin, or you say digitalis. Whatever you say, digoxin kello, digitalis kello, digitoxin kello, one and the same thing. So digoxin, digitoxin, collectively known as digitalis, one and the same thing. So mechanism of action sabka ek hi hai. So I will teach you mechanism of action. So all these drugs, digoxin, digitoxin, or collectively known as digitalis, what they are doing, they are increasing the systole. They are increasing systole of the heart. They are increasing the systole. So before coming to the mechanism of action of digoxin, digitoxin, digitalis, you should know how normally systole takes place. Normal jo hoga, usi ko hum exaggerate kar denge. We will exaggerate the normal mechanism. So heart mein how normal systole and diastole takes place. First I will teach you normal. How normal systole and diastole takes place in a heart. Then I will tell you the mechanism of action of digitalis, which increases only systole, not the diastole. That is the mechanism of action of inotropic drug. This is how simplicity se main tumhe teach karungi. So that is the thing. Listen. First, I will teach you how normally systole and diastole takes place here. So systole and diastole, what do you mean by systole? That is contractility. When the left ventricle is doing contraction, it is known as systole. What is diastole? When the left ventricle is doing relaxation, it is known as diastole. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. You have already studied in physiology how systole, diastole, what is the mechanism, but I have to teach you to explain the mechanism of action of digitalis. You can't directly understand ki digitalis systole ko kaise badhayega. Digitalis will increase the systole definitely, because it is an inotropic drug. Of course it will increase the systole. All inotropic drugs, not only digitalis, it is the phosphodiesterase 3 inhibitors and sympathomimetic drugs, milrinin, amrinin, all of them increase systole. But before understanding how they are increasing systole, you should understand how normal systole take place. How this left ventricle normally doing the contraction, how it is doing the relaxation. Then I will teach you the mechanism of action of the drug. So how, you tell me how normally left ventricle contract. You tell me how it is doing the contraction. It is due to the cells present in the myocardium. Now heart has three layers, na? Endocardium, myocardium, pericardium. So let me talk about myocardium. In the myocardium, these smooth muscle cells are present. Not smooth muscle cells. These are the cardiac myocytes. So can you see? Okay, I will draw a heart for you. So this is the heart. This is the left ventricle, left side. So these are the three layers. This is endocardium. This is endocardium. This is myocardium. Let me draw. This is myocardium. This is myocardium. And this is pericardium. Okay, this is pericardium. I am interested in myocardium. I am interested in myocardium. In the myocardium, these are the cells. These are the cells. These are cardiac myocytes. What are these cells? These are cardiac myocytes. This is the thickest layer in the heart. and it is doing systole and diastole. It is doing systole and diastole. When these cells, when all these cells are doing contraction, systole takes place. Systole takes place. And when these cells are doing relaxation, diastole takes place. So let me take one of these cells and draw it separately. Draw it separately. This is one of the cell where? This is one of the cell of this cardiac myocyte. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. One of the cell. I'm drawing one of the cells separately. One of the cell of cardiac myocyte, the middle layer. So this is a cell. Can you see? This is a cell. This is the cell membrane. See the cell membrane. This is the cell. This is the cell membrane of the cardiac myocyte. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone, if you can understand it. Which cell it is? You even can't understand ki diagram kis cell. ये डायग्राम हार्ट के लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल की मिडिल लेयर मायोकार्डियम का एक सेल है कार्डियक मायोसाइट. गिव मी अ थम्स अप. इट इज डूइंग सिस्टोल एंड डायस्टोल. व्हेनेवर इट इज कॉन्ट्रैक्टिंग सिस्टोल विल टेक प्लेस. व्हेनेवर इट इज रिलैक्सिंग डायस्टोल टेक प्लेस. गिव मी अ थम्स अप एवरीवन. सो हाउ सिस्टोल. लेट मी फर्स्ट एक्सप्लेन यू सिस्टोल. देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू डायस्टोल नॉर्मली बिफोर डिजिटलिस. देन आई विल टेल यू द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ डिजिटलिस. सो दिस इज लिसन. दिस इज अ सेल. This is the cell of left ventricle myocardium. Imagine the four ventricle, four chambers. From the four chambers, imagine left ventricle. Left ventricle have three walls. Endocardium, myocardium, pericardium. Imagine myocardium, middle layer. Myocardium ka ek cell hai, ye cardiac myocyte. Listen, so when systole takes place, when depolarization, when wave of depolarization is coming, then systole takes place. Yes. So when wave of depolarization is coming, this is calcium channel. This is a calcium channel. Can you see? This is voltage gated calcium channel on the cell surface. So calcium channel will get stimulated when wave of depolarization is coming. Listen, so calcium will enter inside the cell. In a small amount of calcium will enter inside the cell. Very small amount, a very small amount of calcium. 1% of the calcium is entering inside. 1% of the calcium. This 1% of the calcium will go to the endoplasmic reticulum, sarcoplasmic reticulum of the cell. Sarcoplasmic reticulum, that is endoplasmic reticulum of the cell. It contains a receptor known as RYR receptor. What is the full form of RYR? This is the full form of RYR. Ranaldin calcium channel. RYR. Ranaldin calcium channel. Ranaldin calcium channel 2. It will stimulate that receptor. Can you see? So calcium is coming inside. It is going, 1% is coming. It is going to sarcoplasmic reticulum. It is stimulating RYR receptors on the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So abundant, rest 99% of the calcium is coming inside it. It is a storage of calcium. So rest of the calcium is coming. So in the cytoplasm, 100% calcium is present now. Initially 0% was present before depolarization. When wave of depolarization is coming, before that zero calcium is present in the cytoplasm. When wave of depolarization is coming, it is stimulating calcium channel on the surface of the cell. So 1% calcium yahan se aa raha hai. It is going to RYR receptor on sarcoplasmic reticulum and rest of the 99% coming from here. So cytoplasm contains 100% calcium. This calcium is going to troponin and stimulating troponin. Troponin will bind with myosin. Stimulating troponin. So troponin will stimulate actin myosin. So actin myosin combination takes place and ultimately contraction takes place. So this is how systole takes place. Contraction means systole. So tell me the story. So wave of depolarization is coming. It is stimulating voltage sensitive calcium channels on the surface of the cardiac myocytes. Small amount of calcium is coming inside, 1% calcium. That is going to RYR receptors on the sarcoplasmic reticulum that triggers the abundant release of calcium, that is remaining 99%. So calcium in the cytoplasm become 100% transiently. It increases too much. So it will activate troponin. Troponin will activate, causes the contraction of cardiac myocytes due to actin myosin combination. Give me a thumbs up. So this is how systole takes place. This is how systole takes place. Now tell me how diastole takes place. Systole to ho gaya. Contraction to ho gaya. Now wave of depolarization is gone. Ab diastole kaise hoga? Diastole kaise hoga? So as soon as one contraction takes place, as soon as one contraction takes place, wave of depolarization is gone. Now there are another receptors on this sarcoplasmic reticulum. The name of these receptors is SARCA. What is the name of this receptor? SARCA. What is the full form of SARCA? This is the full form of SARCA. Please read. It is sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum calcium ATPase. Sarcoplasmic endoplasmic reticulum calcium ATPase 2. It is known as SARCA. SARCA will get activated. So, yahan se jo 99 aaya tha, jo RER ne diya tha 99, उतना 99 ये वापस ले लेगा इन द साइटोप्लाज्म. इन द साइटोप्लाज्म टोटल इमेजिन 100% कैल्शियम इज प्रेजेंट. आउट ऑफ दिस 100, 1% वॉज कमिंग फ्रॉम हियर फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड फ्रॉम कैल्शियम चैनल्स एंड रिमेनिंग 99 वॉज कमिंग फ्रॉम द आरईआर. सो सरका विल टेक जितना आरईआर ने दिया था वो वापस अपने अंदर ले लेगा. सरका विल टेक 99% इन साइड. वॉट एवर गिवन आरईआर इज टेकन बाय द सरका. सो अब साइटोप्लाज्म में कितना बचा? साइटोप्लाज्म में ओनली 1% ऑफ द कैल्शियम इज रिमेनिंग स्टिल नाउ. टिल नाउ लिसन, दिस 1% इज इंपॉर्टेंट. यही पूरा खेल करेगा, यही पूरा खेल करेगा आगे. दिस 1% नॉर्मली क्या होगा? नॉर्मली दिस 1% विल गो हियर. दिस 1% कैल्शियम विल गो टू अनदर रिसेप्टर ऑन द सर्फेस. अनदर रिसेप्टर ऑन द सर्फेस, द नेम ऑफ दिस रिसेप्टर इज सोडियम कैल्शियम एक्सचेंजर. सोडियम, ये 1% कैल्शियम इसको बोलेगा मुझे बाहर निकाल, प्लीज प्लीज थ्रो मी आउट. सो इट विल से ओके, आई एम सोडियम कैल्शियम एक्सचेंजर. I will take calcium out, so I will take sodium inside. It will say okay, so two, one calcium will go out and three sodium will come in. So that is sodium calcium exchanger. So sodium is coming in. Can you see? Sodium is coming in. ये calcium तो अब अंदर zero हो गया. Calcium will become zero. 99% सरका ने ले लिया, बचा हुआ 1% NCX. Sodium calcium exchanger. Sodium NaCa exchanger ने एक्सचेंज कर दिया, लेकिन उसकी कॉस्ट पे सोडियम अंदर आया. तो अब सोडियम को बाहर निकालना है, तो सोडियम को कैसे बाहर निकालोगे? देयर इज अनदर ट्रांसपोर्टर नोन एज सोडियम पोटेशियम एटीपेस. व्हाटएवर सोडियम यहां से अंदर आया वो बाहर चला जाएगा और उसकी जगह पे पोटेशियम आ जाएगा. सो दैट इज द होल स्टोरी. अल्टीमेटली कैल्शियम जीरो हो गया तो यहाँ पे हो जाएगा रिलैक्सेशन, तो हो जाएगा डायस्टोल. Give me a thumbs up. I will draw it for you. Then I will tell you the mechanism of action of digitalis. Now you will understand it better. Give me a thumbs up, everyone. Everyone, let me draw a cell for you. This is a cell. What is this cell? This is a cell known as cardiac myocyte. So imagine the four chambers of the heart. Imagine the left ventricle. Left ventricle have three walls: endocardium, myocardium, pericardium. Imagine the middle layer, myocardium. Myocardium, imagine one cell. This is cardiac myocyte. This is cardiac myocyte. On the cardiac myocyte, there is a voltage gated calcium channel. This is calcium channel. So when wave of depolarization is coming, this is wave of depolarization, it is coming. So this channel will get stimulated. So 1% of the calcium is coming in. 1% of the calcium is coming in. This is sarcoplasmic reticulum. Sarcoplasmic reticulum, it is present. Remaining 99% of the calcium is present inside it. So when 1% of the calcium is coming here, it will go here. And it contains two receptors. So what are the name of the two receptors present on this? One is RYR and second is Sarca. So this 1% calcium is stimulating RYR. RYR will get stimulated and this 99% of the calcium will also come in the blood, in the cytoplasm. So cytoplasm total contains 100% of the calcium. As soon as calcium become 100%, it will stimulate troponin. Troponin will stimulate actin. Actin will combine with myosin. Actin-myosin combination will lead to contraction. Contraction will lead to systole. So this is how systole takes place. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Everyone. This is how systole takes place in heart. Now let me talk about diastole. Now wave of depolarization is gone. Let me take the reverse. Now wave of depolarization is gone. It is gone. Contraction already taken place. Now I have to do the relaxation. I have to do the diastole. So as soon as wave of depolarization is gone, the another receptors, that is Sarca, will get stimulated. Sarca will take this 99% of the calcium inside again. 99 ही बाहर आया था यहाँ से और 99 ही अंदर चला जाएगा. सार्कोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम से 99% कैल्शियम बाहर आने के लिए वी नीड RYR और वापस अंदर लेने के लिए वी नीड Sarca. सो इट इज वेरी सिंपल. उसने 99 दिया, उसने 99 ले लिया. Sarca will say that RYR has given you 99, so I will take 99 again inside me. So our balance is okay. Our balance is clear now. There is no dues between us. Okay, so 99 is taken. Still 1% of the calcium is remaining. Ye 1% kaise bahar niklega? Again, calcium tumhe zero karna padega if you want to do the relaxation. You have to do calcium zero. So what will happen to this 1%? What will happen to this 1%? This 1% is thrown outside by a transporter known as sodium calcium exchanger. So this 1% of the calcium will go here. So calcium will go out, but sodium will come in. Sodium will come in. So what will happen to this sodium? There is third transporter known as sodium potassium exchanger. Sodium potassium ATPase. So whatever sodium coming from here, it will go out and potassium is coming in. Potassium will remain there only. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Now, let me tell you the mechanism of digitalis in this diagram only. Should I tell you? Okay, digitalis. Digitalis inhibit this sodium potassium ATPase. अब पूरा उल्टा चला, उससे सिस्टोल कैसे बढ़ेगा? It is an inotropic drug. It is increasing the systole. So what is happening? What is happening? Start the story from the beginning. So 1% wave of depolarization is coming. Okay, 1% calcium entering from the. Okay, I will explain you here only. Wave of depol. Let me explain you the mechanism of action of digitalis. Digitalis. Digitalis is inhibiting this. Can you see digoxin digitalis inhibiting sodium potassium ATPase? So you will ask me कि ma'am इसको inhibit करने से systole कैसे बढ़ा? So okay, I will explain you how systole is increased. Digitalis is a inotropic drug, so it is increasing systole, not the diastole. It is stimulating the systole, more systole. So how? By inhibiting sodium potassium ATPase. So how it is happening? Listen. Start the story from the beginning. Wave of depolarization is coming as it is normally, as it is coming, it is coming. So 1% of the calcium is entering inside through this so voltage gated calcium channel. 1% of the calcium is going inside. It is stimulating RYR. So 99% of the calcium is coming from here. So total 100% of the calcium is there. Normally jaise hota hai waisa hi ho raha hai. It is stimulating troponin. Troponin is stimulating actin and myosin and contraction taking place. Yahan tak to sab normal hai. Yahan sab to it is like normal only. There is no nothing different. It is like normal only. Yahan tak to normal hai. Now, अब क्या होता है? Normally क्या होता है? Now sarca will get stimulated. Here also sarca will get stimulated. Sarca will take 99% of the calcium. ठीक है, 99 तो गया. What about 1%? What about 1%? Normally 1% को कौन निकालता है? 1% को ये निकालता है. Sodium calcium exchanger. तो ये 1% इसके पास जाएगा. This 1% calcium will say to NCX that throw me out. Please throw me out. Heart wants to do the diastole. But this will not throw him out. Why? Because अगर इसको throw किया बाहर तो सोडियम लेना पड़ेगा, लेकिन सोडियम लिया तो सोडियम पोटेशियम एटीपेस तो ऑलरेडी इनहिबिटेड है, और सोडियम का हार्ट करेगा क्या? वो सोडियम को बाहर नहीं निकाल सकते, पोटेशियम अंदर नहीं ले सकते, तो ये काम नहीं करेगा. ये काम नहीं करेगा तो 1% विल रिमेन इनसाइड ओनली. दिस इज ट्रैप्ड. दिस 1% कैल्शियम इज ट्रैप्ड इन द हार्ट बिकॉज ऑफ डिजिटलिस. सो दिस 1% अगेन विल गो टू सार्कोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड अगेन इट विल स्टिमुलेट आरवाईआर. Again 99% will come and again systole will take place. So that is how systole is exaggerated. Give me a thumbs up if you got it. I really tried hard. So what is the mechanism of action of digitalis? It is inhibiting sodium potassium ATPase. Sodium potassium ATPase inhibit ho gaya, so sodium andar bad jayega. There is more sodium inside. It cannot go outside. So calcium exchange nahi hoga. Calcium will not be exchanged. Okay, let me synthesis. So whenever you give digitalis, sodium potassium ATPase is inhibited. So there is decreased sodium will go outside. So intracellular sodium will increase. So sodium calcium exchanger will not work because of increased concentration of. वो बोलेगा already sodium बहुत है. मैं तुम्हें बाहर निकालूंगा तो और sodium अंदर लेना पड़ेगा. I cannot do that. So this exchanger will not work. So that 1% calcium will be trapped in the cell. That will further stimulate RYR of the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Again 99% will come. It will stimulate troponin. Troponin will go to myosin. Actin myosin combination will take place again and again and again. Contraction, contraction, contraction. Increase systole, increase systole, increase systole. That is the mechanism of action of inotropic drug. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a big thumbs up. Have you got it? Have you got it? That is the mechanism of action of digitalis. Digitalis inhibit this. Ye nahi kaam karega to sodium potassium exchange nahi hoga. Sodium will not go outside. So sodium concentration here, it will increase. Potassium will, sodium concentration increase intracellularly because this is not functioning and potassium is not coming in. So potassium concentration will increase extracellularly. Iska bhi ek importance hai. That's why I am telling you. Potassium concentration will increase extracellularly. Since there is more sodium inside, so this will not function. It will say I am already having more sodium in the cell. So if I exchange calcium, if I exchange calcium, 1% of the calcium is requesting the sodium calcium exchanger that please throw me out. So this is not throwing him out, throwing calcium out, because if the sodium calcium exchanger throw the calcium out, it has to take sodium and there is already more sodium in the cell. So it is not functioning. So that 1% of the calcium is trapped inside. That will again go to SR. SR ke paas jayega, it will stimulate RYR. It will stimulate RYR. Again 99% will come. Again contraction will take place. Again. So that is the mechanism of action of inotropic drug. Have you got it? So the same diagram showing here also. So you can see this cell, please appreciate this cell. this is a cell of cardiac myocyte, cardiac cell, the middle layer, cardiac cell. So you can see three pumps on it. One is voltage gated calcium channel. Okay, let me draw with another color. One is sodium calcium exchanger, sodium calcium. One is sodium potassium exchanger or sodium potassium ATPase. So digitalis is inhibiting this one. If this one is inhibiting, so this one is not functional, but it is not inhibited. It is not functioning because this is not functioning. It is not functioning, so 1% of the calcium is trapped. So that is the whole story. It is again and again going to SR and stimulating RYR, and more calcium is coming, causing contraction by actin myosin. Everyone give me a thumbs up. Now I will tell you three important points here. One by one. Action of digitalis is not quick. If I give, there is a patient in front of me who is having heart failure. Acute heart failure. The patient is having acute heart failure. So his left ventricle is not functioning. The left ventricle is not pumping. So this is the layer. Okay, let me draw. This is the middle layer. And these are the cardiac myocytes in the middle layer. So if I give digitalis tablet, if I give digitalis to this patient, this is digitalis tablet. Okay. So this is digitalis. If I give digitalis tablet, it comes in the form of a tablet. So if the patient is taking this tablet, so digitalis is acting on these cells. In these cells and increasing the contraction, but once it will go inside, it will inhibit the pump, sodium potassium exchanger, sodium potassium ATPase. Yes, it is inhibiting the pump. Iski wajah se sodium calcium exchanger will not function, aur uski wajah se 1% of the calcium is trapped. So it will show its action. So action is delayed. It will take many hours to show its action. It is not quick. So if you want immediate result, give dopamine or dobutamine. Digitalis action is delayed. It is not immediate. Number one. Have you got it? Number two. If I give patient tablet of digitalis, where it will go? It will go in the mouth. From the mouth, it will go to the esophagus. From esophagus, it will go to the stomach and intestine. From stomach and intestine, it will be absorbed. It will go in the blood. Via blood, it will go to the heart. In the heart, here it is present. And here is the pump. Listen, here is the pump, sodium potassium ATPase. Normally, potassium is going inside. Now, this is potassium. It is going inside and sodium is coming out when digitalis is absent. But now digitalis is also present. Digitalis also want to go in. And potassium also want to go in. So there is a competition. There is a competition between potassium and digitalis. There is a competition between who will go. The one who is having more concentration will go. If digitalis is having more concentration, it will go. If potassium is having more concentration, it will go. Give me a thumbs up. So if concentration of potassium is less, that is hypokalemia, more digitalis will enter inside and it will cause toxicity. Digitalis toxicity is really very, bothersome. It will cause arrhythmia. You can't increase its action. Uska zyada inotropic action hanikarak hai. So hypokalemia, reduced potassium increases the toxicity of digitalis because there is a competition between the two. Who will enter? Potassium will enter or digitalis will enter? Who will enter? There is a competition. So if you reduce the potassium, digitalis will enter more. So it will cause toxicity. So number one point, hypokalemia increases the toxicity of digitalis. This is the reason. Number two, if in the blood, just suppose in my blood, calcium is more. What is the normal calcium concentration? It is 9 to 11 milligram per deciliter. If there is more calcium in my blood, if I'm taking a calcium supplement, calcium tablets or something, more calcium. And if I'm taking digitalis also. So digitalis kya karega? Digitalis increases the contractility by its mechanism, by inhibiting this pump. And calcium also increases the contractility. Calcium apne aap mein bhi contractility badhayega. So again, it increases the toxicity. So there are two things. Reduced potassium and increased calcium, both causes toxicity of digitalis. Give me a thumbs up. So let me summarize. Hypokalemia and hypercalcemia, confuse nahi hona hai. Hypokalemia, that is potassium kam, that is reduced potassium, and hypercalcemia, that is increased calcium, both of them increases the chances of digitalis toxicity. Everyone again give me a thumbs up. There are two important PYQs based on this concept. You can't afford to miss it. नाउ लर्न तो सभी करते हैं ना, लेकिन लर्न करोगे तो भूल जाओगे, एक बार समझ लोगे तो कभी नहीं भूलोगे. और नाउ यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट कि हाइपोकैलेमिया से डिजिटलिस्ट टॉक्सिसिटी क्यों होती है, बिकॉज यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द मैकेनिज्म ना. देयर इज कॉम्पिटिशन बिटवीन पोटेशियम एंड डिजिटलिस्ट, तो एक कम होगा तो दूसरा बढ़ेगा ना, इनवर्स रिलेशन है. एक ही गेट है, दोनों घुसने को एक दूसरे को धक्का मार रहे हैं कि मैं घुसूंगा मैं घुसूंगा, तो एक को कम कर दो तो दूसरा ज्यादा घुसेगा. सो दैट इज द थिंग, सो दैट इज अ कॉम्पिटिशन बिटवीन द टू, ओनली वन गेट इज देयर. तो पोटेशियम डिक्रीज, डिजिटलिस्ट टॉक्सिसिटी इंक्रीज. और कैल्शियम बढ़ेगा तो डिजिटलिस्ट टॉक्सिसिटी बढ़ेगा. क्यों? बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ देम कॉजेस द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन. डिजिटल इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ एक्टिन मायोसिन, एंड कैल्शियम ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ एक्टिन मायोसिन. सो बोथ विल एक्ट बाय डिफरेंट मैकेनिज्म एंड इंक्रीजिंग द कॉन्ट्रैक्शन बिटवीन एक्टिन एंड मायोसिन एंड इंक्रीजेस द टॉक्सिसिटी. गिव मी अ थम्स अप. सो नाउ यू विल नेवर फॉरगेट, हाइपोकैलेमिया एंड हाइपरकैल्सेमिया बोथ इंक्रीजेस द टॉक्सिसिटी ऑफ डिजिटल. Please learn this point in the mechanism of action. So I have explained you the mechanism of action of digitalis. Digitalis कह लो, digoxin कह लो, digitoxin कह लो, one and the same thing. Question में कुछ भी आए, digitalis आ जाए, digoxin आ जाए, digitoxin आ जाए. Give me a comment in the comment box. Have you got it? Yes, no, any doubt, any positive comment, any negative comment, anything, write something. Na? So I will have a understanding that what is going on, actually what is going on. Okay. Okay. Let me move further. Okay. So give me some comment. Have you got it? Yes or no? Should I move further? So should I tell you the actions of digitalists? So I'm going to tell you the action of digitalists on four organs, on the heart, on the blood vessels, on the kidney, and on the CNS. On the heart, you already know. One action you already know, it is increasing the contraction. Okay. On the heart, I will tell you four actions. One you already know, it increases the contraction. That is, it increases the force of contraction. That is, it is showing positive inotropic effect. It is showing positive inotropic effect. Second, it increases the excitability. So that's why there is always a chance of arrhythmia if you give digitalist tablet to the patient. If you give a digitalist tablet to any patient, there is a chance of arrhythmia, because along with increasing the contraction, it increases the, you know, the excitability of SA node, excitability of the conducting fibers, you know, the SA node and AV node. So excitability bhi badha dega, lekin velocity kam kar dega. It decreases the velocity, so it causes bradycardia. It stimulates vagal center, which have depressant action on the velocity of SA and AV node. So it causes refractoriness, it causes bradycardia, and ECG changes. These are the ECG changes that you will study in medicine also. In medicine also, you will study this. It increases PR interval, decrease QT interval, increase the amplitude or inversion of the T wave, and ST depression. Can you see? So it is ST depression. It is ST depression, like ST elevation seen in MI. It is ST depression. So that is the thing. Listen, in heart, there are four things. Force of contraction, excitability, velocity. It increases force of contraction, so positive inotropic effect. It decreases excitability. It increases excitability, so causes arrhythmia. But it decreases velocity, so causes bradycardia. Now these two things are opposite, huh? Don't get confused. Arrhythmia and bradycardia are different things. In arrhythmia, you know, there is more and more excitability is there. In bradycardia, heart rate is reduced. So two things are opposite, but two things can occur together. Patient will go in arrhythmia along with bradycardia. So increase force of contraction with arrhythmia, with bradycardia, along with ECG changes. Give me a thumbs up. What is the effect on blood vessels? It causes vasodilatation. It causes contraction dilatation, but net effect is vasodilatation. No prominent effect on blood pressure. What is the effect on kidney? It causes diuresis. It increases the blood flow in the kidney, so it increases urine output. Listen, imagine why it is happening. Imagine these are the two kidneys. This is aorta. Let me draw aorta. From the aorta, these are the renal artery. This aorta is coming from the heart. Okay, let me draw the heart. These are the four chambers of the heart. From the left ventricle, this is the aorta coming out. From the left ventricle, this is the aorta. Initially, heart was in failure. Okay, so let me write heart failure here. This is heart failure. So the left ventricle was not contracting. So less blood was coming in the aorta. So less blood was going in the renal artery. So less GFR. So less urine was there. Now you have given digitalis. So what digitalis is doing? It is an inotropic drug. So suddenly it is increasing the contraction of the heart. So more blood is going in the aorta. So more blood is going in the renal artery. So suddenly increase in GFR. So increase in urine output. So it is causing diuresis. Give me a thumbs up if you got the reason for diuresis. So it causes diuresis. Digital is what causes diuresis. Now you will never forget. CNS. In the CNS, there is a center in CNS which is known as CTZ. You know CTZ. It stimulates CTZ. Because of stimulation of CTZ, patient feels nausea and vomiting. It is a side effect of digital. Most common extra cardiac side effect of digital is this feeling of nausea and vomiting because it causes stimulation of CTZ. Give me a thumbs up. So tell me the mechanism, actions on these four organs. Who will tell me? Please interact with me. No, it is a live lecture. You have an opportunity to interact with me. Yes, on the heart, tell me three things. What about force? Force or contractility, whether it will be increased or decreased. What about excitability? What about velocity? Digitalis causes what? So yes, it increases force, it increases excitability, it decreases velocity. Because of increase in force of contraction, there is positive inotropic effect. That is known as inotropic drug. Because of increase in excitability, there is always a chance of arrhythmia. That is a side effect of the digitalis. There is a complication or side effect of digitalis. Decrease velocity, there is always a chance of bradycardia. Patient can go in bradycardia. What is the effect on blood vessels? It is causing vasodilatation. What is the effect on kidney? It is causing diuresis. You know the reason. What is the effect on CNS? It stimulates CTZ. That's why causing nausea and vomiting, which is again an extra cardiac side effect. So cardiac side effect mein most common is arrhythmia. Extra cardiac side effect mein most common is nausea and vomiting. Give me a thumbs up. So side effect profile bhi cover hota ja raha hai. So you know the drugs, inotropic drugs, you know mechanism of action very well, you know what is causing toxicity, hypokalemia and hypercalcemia is causing toxicity. You know mechanism of action, it is inhibiting sodium potassium ATPase on the cardiac myocytes. This pump is inhibited. You know the action on four organs. Let me come on pharmacokinetics. This is the pharmacokinetics. You have to learn this table. Digitoxin and digoxin. You have to learn. Digitoxin is obtained from a plant, digitoxin purpura. And digoxin is obtained from a plant known as digitalis lantana. Both of them together known as digitalis. Digitalis is the umbrella term. Talis is the umbrella term which contains both digoxin and digitoxin. So digitalis is the umbrella term. Absorption is 100% good of digitoxin. And digoxin it is 60 to 80%. Done. Plasma protein binding, you have to learn. Is pe MCQ aata hai. You will get a PYQ on this. Is pe already question aa chuka hai. What is the plasma protein binding of digitoxin and digoxin? There is a great difference. You should know. And you should know elimination also. This is excreted by liver and this is excreted by kidney. You should know the elimination. So here in liver failure, you have to do the adjustment, dose adjustment. And here in kidney failure, you have to do the dose adjustment. So there is a patient, there are two patients in front of me, patient A, patient B. Patient A is cirrhotic, having liver failure. Patient B is having renal failure, is diabetic. And because of diabetes, he is having diabetic renopathy, nephropathy. So he is having renal failure. So two patients, so in this patient, I cannot give digitoxin, I will give digoxin. And in this patient, I cannot give digoxin, I will give digitoxin. So that is how you have to balance. Done, have you got it? Okay, uses, this is given for maintenance, this is given for emergency. Because you know T half, you can see the T half, and based on that, that is the thing, and you should know this. Okay, let me come pharmacokinetics ke baad, let me come on uses. Uses only two uses are there. In heart failure, it is showing an inotropic effect, and in arrhythmia, it is causing bradycardia. Because it causes bradycardia also, so it can be useful in arrhythmia. Give me a thumbs up. So two uses are there. So uses ke baad, adverse effects. What are the adverse effects? So adverse effects are very common because safety margin is low. So therapeutic range is 1.5 to 3 milligram per deciliter in the blood. If it is more than 3 milligram, it will cause side effects. Side effects are of two types, extracardiac and cardiac. Extracardiac mein most common side effect is nausea, vomiting because of stimulation of CTZ center in the brain. CTZ stimulation, that is the earliest and most common extracardiac side effect. And among cardiac, most common are the arrhythmias. Which arrhythmias? All arrhythmia. All arrhythmia can be caused by digitalis, digoxin, digitoxin. Except Mobis type 2 and atrial flutter. These are the two arrhythmias which are not caused by digitalis. Rest, all arrhythmias can be caused by digitalis. It can be tachyarrhythmia, ventricular arrhythmia, supraventricular arrhythmia and AV block. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. So arrhythmias are really very, very, very important. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. Everyone give me a thumbs up. We are done with adverse effects, contraindications. These are the contraindications. There is a mnemonic for contraindication. Okay, I will tell you the mnemonic. Contraindicated in weak heart. Contraindicated in weak heart. So contraindicated ka jo C hai, that is for carditis. Don't give digitalis to any carditis patient. Inka jo I hai, it is increased calcium. Don't give it in hypercalcemia. You know the reason why. It will cause digitalis toxicity. W is WPW syndrome. Don't give digitalis to any patient having WPW syndrome. H is a hypokalemia. Hypokalemia. You know hypokalemia. E say elderly. Don't give it in elderly because there is always a chance elderly patient have a weak kidneys and because of renal failure, there is chance of digitalis toxicity. Don't give it in AV block. AV block doge to aur bradycardia ki wajah se partial AV block will get converted into complete AV block. Don't give it in renal failure. There is always a chance of toxicity. Don't give it in thyroid patient because of hyper or hypothyroidism. Both thyroid matter. Give me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. So contraindicated in weak heart. H-E-A-R-T. Tell me the full form. Contraindicated in ka I, weak ka W, H-E-A-R-T. You know the full form? Yes, you know the full form. Carditis. I say increased calcium hai. Or H say hypokalemia hai. W se WPW syndrome hai. E say elderly. A say I just forgot. T say thyroid. R say renal failure. A say kya tha? A se kya tha? AV block, partial AV block. So give me a thumbs up, everyone. Interactions you can read by yourself, not really important. Interactions you can read yourself. So I'm done with the chapter. I am done with the chapter. So there are few polls in front of you. So time is limited. So I will solve few of them. Okay. So have you got it? Any problem in understanding anything? You can ask me. Any problem in the drugs, in mechanism of action, in actions, in pharmacokinetics, in uses, adverse effects, contraindication ke liye mnemonic. I have told you the mnemonic, contraindicated in weak heart, H-E-A-R-T. You should know the full form. You will never forget. 50% of the MCQs are from the drugs. 50% of the many MCQs are from mechanism of action and remaining are from contraindication and adverse. So maximum MCQs aapke yahin se aayenge. Give me a thumbs up, everyone, everyone. You want me to launch the polls? Okay, I will. So this is the first poll in front of you. Please read the question and tell me the correct answer in the chat box. So positive inotropic effect of digitalis is due to inhibition of sodium potassium ATPase pump. We know. It will lead to what? Because of inhibition, what will happen? Because of inhibition, what will happen? So it is a big question, but very important. It is asked many times in the previous year questions. Read the options. So what is the sodium potassium ATPase pump inhibition due to digitalis lead to? Which will lead to positive inotropic effect. Uski wajah se kya hoga? Uski wajah se kya hoga? Read the four options and tell me the correct answer in the chat box. Write A, B, C, D, whatever you think. Kya ho raha hai? Sodium potassium ATPase pump will inhibit, so the concentration of sodium will be more inside the cell. So another pump known as sodium calcium exchanger, NCX, will not function because there is already more concentration of sodium in the cell. So NCX will not function, so calcium will not go out. 1% of the calcium will be trapped inside the cell and that will again and again stimulate the sarcoplasmic reticulum RYR receptor and causes positive inotropic effect. So Dr. Huzaifa is saying B. Is it B? I don't know, Huzaifa. Is it B? Yes or no? Tell me others. What others are saying? What others are saying? So Arpit Jain is saying A. Vignesh is saying A. Huzaifa B. Rest of the people are with A. Yes, whether it is A or B. So no, Huzaifa, you are wrong. It is A. So most of you are saying A. Prem is also saying A. Yes. So A is the correct answer. So decrease activity of sodium calcium exchanger. Because of inhibition of sodium potassium pump, sodium calcium exchanger will not function, causing decrease influx of sodium and decrease efflux of the calcium. So calcium will cause decrease efflux. It will get trapped. 1% will get trapped and again contraction. So A is the correct answer. Have you got it? Have you got it? So why B is not the correct answer? Let me be read B also. Some of you have said B now. Decrease efflux of sodium lead to negative resting membrane potential and opening. No, it is not the thing. Huzaifa, you are wrong here. Have you got it? Have you got it, everyone? Okay. Those who are wrong, they also got it now. Why A is the correct answer, not the B one? Everyone give me a thumbs up. Okay, this is the next question in front of you. Question contains except. Please mind it. Tell me the correct answer. Okay, I will read the question for you people. digoxin toxicity is increased by all except. So digoxin toxicity is increased by all except. अच्छा कैल्शियम और मैग्नीशियम साथ में चलेंगे आई गेस कैल्शियम और मैग्नीशियम विल गो टुगेदर बिकॉज बोथ ऑफ देम आर 2+ आयन बोथ ऑफ देम आर 2+ आयन यू कैन से कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम विल गो टुगेदर नो यू ऑल आर रॉन्ग मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर सेइंग ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर ए इज नॉट द करेक्ट आंसर बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर हाइपरकैलेमिया नहीं हाइपोकैलेमिया इंक्रीजेस द टॉक्सिसिटी हाइपोकैलेमिया व्हाई यू आर सेइंग ए hypokalemia I have told you na two things which increases the toxicity one is hypokalemia one is hypercalcemia ke sath hypermagnesemia bhi likh lo aap hypercalcemia and hypermagnesemia both increases kyunki calcium magnesium one and the same thing learn like that both of them are +2 ions so hypercalcemia okay it is not hypomagnesemia okay so two options will be there hyperkalemia and hypomagnesemia both will be incorrect na b and d will be the answer Not A. Why you are saying A? Yes, B. B is the answer here. D, B है वहाँ पे, but go with B. Done. All of the following drugs. Okay, ये तो interactions पे है. Okay. So that you can do the questions by yourself. I'm skipping it. Okay. Give me the answer of this one. The mechanism of action of digitals. Who will tell me the mechanism of action of digitals? What is the mechanism of action of digitals? What it is doing? What it is doing? Yes. What is the correct answer? What is the correct answer? Read the four options: increase in heart rate, decrease in heart rate, increase in oxygen consumption, decrease in oxygen consumption. Yes. The correct answer here is D. It is causing decrease in heart rate. It is causing bradycardia. I have told you very specifically. It increases force, increases excitability, but decreases velocity. So it decreases heart rate and decreases oxygen consumption. So the correct answer here is D. You all are right. What is the mechanism of action of digitalis? Same question with different options. Who will tell me? It is very easy. It is very easy. The four options are in front of you. Is it inhibiting sodium potassium ATPase pump or sodium proton ATPase pump or active metabolite produced in the liver or inhibit calcium concentration in the blood? What it is doing? Who will tell me the correct answer? It's very easy question. Yes, most of you are right. The correct answer here is, of course, yes. What it is? Yes, you all are right. The correct answer here is, of course, A. It inhibits sodium potassium ATPase pump. So you have to understand the question and listen. This question is also a PYQ. It is asked in one of the previous year question. Aubain acts by. You should know what is Aubain. Aubain is one of the inotropic drug from this category only. It is the digitalis ka hi bhai hai Aubain. So the correct answer here will be D. So digitalis ka hi mechanism of action Aubain ke liye bhi hoga. So you should know the classification properly. So the correct answer here is D. Done. So that is how you have to do the questions. Okay. So here I have to stop. Let me announce my next lecture. Then you people can quit. Just a second. So thank you very much for being with me. I really enjoyed teaching you. Hopefully same from your side also. Don't forget to write your feedback in the chat box right now. And my next class. Tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. onwards, I'm having three classes, one at 9 a.m., one at 10:15 a.m., and the third is at 11:30 a.m. So I'm having three classes in the morning, tomorrow onwards. For today, there is no third class. So tomorrow, I'm having the first class of micro, then the second class of pharma, and the third class is of patho. In the micro, I will start Helminth, Metazoa tomorrow. In the pharma, I will continue with antihypertensive drugs. Tomorrow, I will teach you antihypertensive drugs. And in the patho, I will continue with GIT, systemic pathology GIT. So don't dare to miss tomorrow's lecture. All three classes are really very important. If you want more detailed lectures and recordings along with notes PDF, it is available free of cost. It is available free of cost where? On an Academy Learners app. So go to the Play Store. Who are newcomers, go to the Play Store. Install an Academy Learners app from the Play Store. Go to the NEET PG category. Search my name. My name is Dr. Priyanka Sachdev. Please search my name there. You will find my name. And after finding my name under educators, please with the profile link given. Please follow my profile link there. If you follow my profile link there, you will get the notifications of all free classes, number one, and you will get a list of lectures taken by me. All of them are available for free. More than 500 lectures are available on many topics from patho, pharma, and micro. All the lectures are free. The only thing, you require a code to unlock it. The code to unlock it is Sachdev Tan. That is my surname only. S-A-C-H-D-E-V. Sachdev Tan is the code. So please use the code and get the benefit out of it. Along with the free classes, there are two paid subscriptions available on Unacademy. One is Plus subscription, one is Iconic subscription. Plus subscription, you will get access for live and recorded lectures on Unacademy. In Plus subscription, from India's topmost educator. In Iconic, along with Unacademy, you will get access to prep letter recorded lectures also. So you will get best from two of the best. So better to go with Iconic as compared to Plus if you are thinking of taking a Plus paid subscription, because the price difference between the two is little, but you are getting an additional benefit of prep letter also. So that is the thing. If you take a paid subscription, you will also get access to the question bank available on the paid platform. So there are more than 25,000 high yielding questions available there from the latest exams. Image based, clinical, integrated. So you can practice till you become perfect. And these are the batches available on the paid platform. One is batch for NEXT, one is batch for FMG, one is batch for INICT, clinical examination and procedure, from the India's topmost educators. So if you take the subscription, you will get access to all these batches. So whatever you want to learn, you can learn in that batch. Done. So your selection will be guaranteed. That is my words. Take my words. Done. And if you take a subscription for 12 months, you will get 2 months additional. If you get a subscription for 24 months, you will get 4 months additional. So the offer is limited. Take the advantage of it. These are the various plans available. You can see the details of the plan on the Unacademy Learners app. Go to the app. You can select whether you want Iconic or whether you want Plus. First select that. Then select the duration of the plan you want. What is the duration of plan you want? You want minimum one month is also available. Maximum 4 years is also available. In Iconic, minimum 12 months and maximum 4 years is available. Check the price for various subscription. All the prices are very economic. You can choose the plan of your wish, and there is an exciting news for you. The exciting news is that whatever plan you are choosing, you can get further 10% discount on the price. On this existing price, you will get more discount if you apply my code. My code is Sachdev10. That is an authentic code. Please remember the code SACHDEV, Sachdev10. If you apply the code before payment, you will get additional 10% discount. So please take the advantage of it. The code. So the summary is that the code is useful for all students, whether you want paid subscription or want to study only free classes. If you want to take paid subscription, you will get 10% discount if you apply it before payment. And if you want to study only free classes, do not want to join the batches, then you can unlock the free classes only, not the paid one. You can unlock free only by using this code. So please help me in distributing this code to all the medicos of the world. Everywhere, your friends, your colleagues, your seniors, juniors, batchmates, interns, first prof, second prof, pre-final, final, intern, everyone. Please distribute this code so that you can help them for watching free classes also and for taking the paid subscription on a discount rate also. So thank you very much, and don't forget to join me tomorrow morning for the three